Overall, my name's Captain Jack, and welcome back to Space Engineers. Today, we're doing another Star Wars creation spotlight from a workshop. And as you can guess from the title, it's by Perfect Blinky, the master of Star Wars vanilla builds. Anyway, today we have the Z-85 Headhunter, the Z-95 Headhunter, and another variation of the Z-95. Now, these ships, or fighters, are all precursors to the X-Wing fighter, which we've seen in the latest movie and all the original movies. So in the Clone Wars, you would have seen the Z-85, and this fighter, when it appeared in the Clone Wars, was really sleek and really gave a feel to like the beginning of the X-Wing. But at the same time, you also saw this in some games, especially, what's the game called? Empire at War, that one. You could see this one in there quite often, so that's definitely cool. As well as this one, and this one's more of a missile platform. So it's like a different variation. This one's more upgraded, whereas this one's like the more Alliance War one. This is like the post-war, post-Civil War, and this one's kind of like we scrapped it together in a hurry. Anyway, let's take a look. So looking around the build, you've got this brilliant nose pointer thing here, which really just homes in on how sleek the Z-85 is. You've got these engines here for your stopping. The wings curve round, which I really like seeing on Starfighters, is when the wings curve round like that. It's amazing, you don't see many like that. On the back, we have an oxygen generator feeding into a large hydrogen tank there. Then we've got small thrusters here. I think we've got some more underneath. Yeah, we do. I could use spectator, but oh well. I did forget to point out, we've got Gatling's guns here. So the only problem with this fighter I have is no Gatling guns up front, or a rocket launch for that matter. So it's incredibly hard to like aim with this one. Unless you're attacking big targets, it's not gonna do very well. So, because you're kind of needing close range, I think, because, I don't know, personally I prefer like cannons compact on the nose, but a lot of people do prefer them split on the wings. It's all up to personal preference, really. That's kind of it for systems. You've got the gyros packed in here and reactors and stuff, which is really good to pack them in there, because it kind of hides them away, really. This thing is very sleek and nice to fly. I really like it. So I prefer flying this one. Even though it doesn't have like good enough weapon systems for my liking, it is still really nice to fly. Alright, moving on to the Z-95. Kind of got a different layout over here. We've got looks like the beginning of the X-Wing drive pods, doesn't it? We've got gyros here. Moving on, we've got the laser cannons here, or the Gatling guns for us. We also do have a rocket launcher up in the nose front this time. Look at that, rocket launcher there. So you can have torpedo bombings. More thrusters down here. It's just, I think this might have more maneuverability because it's like smaller. Moving around the back, we have four thrusters now to press along, so this is a lot faster. And I think this is a hydrogen tank, isn't it? Yes, it is. Hydrogen tank small. So there's no oxygen generator on this, unless it's hidden in there. Let's hop in a minute. There is one in there. That's what's hidden in there. Ah, smart Blinky, smart. That's kind of it for this one. I mean, you've got the main systems there, which are just highlighted. All packed nicely in here, which is really good. Obviously, you've got blast doors. I love it when people use blast doors on things to emulate that. That's kind of it for that one. Moving over to the like newer version, you've got more rocket pods here. Do you still have the center one? No, you don't have the center one anymore. But you do have this like, it's almost like a missile platform. So you've got these two here, standard laser cannons. This time the vents seem sealed over, but you still got more of a, like a raw, uncovered back on this one. Whereas this one's more covered, this one's like got it uncovered. Yeah, this one's good as well. I like this one. I think if I had to choose one to fly out of these two, it'd probably be the blue variation over here, simply because it's got more rockets. Then this one over here, I'd probably fly this one because it's annoying. Enjoying, I think. Right, let's give this one a try. So let's take off. And this one just flies beautifully, I think. I mean, look at how good it looks. I mean, you saw it in the little trailer I did at the start of the video of how good it looks. Let's take a dive. Hopefully we're not going to hit anything. But I think this one just looks majestic flying along. Look at that. Amazing. Anyway, if we bring it in for a landing, excuse the wreckage field down here. That was something I was testing with earlier. I got bored and thought, let's blow a few ships up. Anyway, if we take this one back to the landing platform, we'll give the other one a test. Now this one has Gatling guns as a weapon, as I explained earlier. I don't know why it has a rocket on here, because it's not. But oh well. So we've got Gatlin's, that's kind of about it. You see like the arc, it kind of like sprays out on the sides here. And I think we're not, oh dear. Well, you guys do like it when I break his things, so, oh, there goes that. Bye Z-85, thank you. All right, where are we? Over here. So, let's try the next one and see if the same happens there. What happened there? God, for every world I have in Space Engineers is a mess. Right, let's give the Z95 a try, and this one's the standard Alliance version. And obviously we've got our rocket pods. I wonder if that 85 is still here. I think it is.
Is it still here?
Where did we crash it? Oh, it's there. Let's target it. Oh, missed. On target. So this is what I like. I like it when the rockets are in the center, because you've got more of like a control of fire arcs. If they're on the wing edges, some of the Gatling guns here, like they're on the wing edges, it's kind of hard to pinpoint it. Like here, I'm not going to get a shot on that fighter. I think it only kind of works close range. That's why most of my fire designs, like the 302, only have things in the center. Because the wings usually get shot off. Oh, we didn't crash this one for a while. Let's just change. Spoke too soon. Oh my, what the hell do we do there? Okay. That was weird. Oh, Blinky, your ship really does have a good eject feature right there. I mean, there's one wing over there and the other's there. Right, let's give the other one a try. Now, this one's got more rockets on it. So, let's bring up in the air, and I believe number 3 is for it. Yes, number 3. Ooh, that does a bit of impact. Damn those hydrogen thrusters. There we go, look at that. Bam. This one's much better. I prefer this one. Because you've got the rocket pods here. So don't mind the rocket pods on the wingtips here, because you've kind of got more of a spread. They're closer in. With the Gatling guns, I'm just not seeing, look, I'm not able to hit that ship unless I just aim one at it. So that's why I prefer them in the center, because then you've got two. Whereas these two, just about hit everything. There we go, look at that, pure destruction. Right, so I suppose we should see how this survives a crash landing. I'd love to see how this survives going down the mountain. But as we probably can't stop in time. Oh, yeah, we're gonna stop. Oh. Blinky, I'm sorry. We're about to completely wreck this. Oh. Oh, I got taken out instantly. Wow, that thing flew apart. Jesus. Look at that wreckage just bouncing down here. Anyway, people, if you, that's not the right thing to pick up. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to give it a like rating. It's been amazing producing this one, and I love reviewing Blinky Star Wars builds. So let me know if you want any more of these, because look at it, it's amazing. Pure amazing. Let's hop in this one. So as usual, let me know by like rating, and subscribe if you feel like you want to see more of these. We've generally got more reviews on the way, because Blinky's got an entire workshop for me to play around with. I believe he's bringing out, I don't know whether the full-size acclimator's coming out soon. He's got his 15% sized out. And I did do a review on the gunship, didn't I? Yeah, the review of the gunship was done. Might have to do that one again, it was nice. Like I said, if you enjoyed this video, don't give it a like rating, all that jazz. Join the Steam group, follow me on Twitter, Facebook, support my Patreon, yada yada yada, all that stuff. And don't forget to check out Blinky's workshop in the description and his YouTube channel. It's been amazing recording this video, and I hope you enjoyed it. Good day. Whoops.